This has taken me a long time to learn that many in religion, those who have never been in religion, and those who are freshly out of religion, do not grasp or understand the difference between liberal, moderate, and conservative branches of religion. Since getting out of religion, I've slowly dealt with many liberal and Christian Muslims. You don't hear from them or about them that much at all because they keep to themselves, even though the liberals and moderates of both religions make up the majority worldwide. A conservative Muslim or Christian believes that their holy book is 100% true and as much like the Constitution as they will lawyer it up in differing ways and disagree with many other conservatives on major or minor points. They don't even believe themselves to be interpreting the scripture, they just believe anyone else's interpretation is lying. They will follow and preach it to their own level of knowledge, and there are varying shades of correct interpretation of the Holy Book, but they all believe that their interpretation is 100% correct, and people outside are evil or misled. This is the kind of religion myself and many of the religious people here on YouTube grew up with. The further away from my beliefs you were, the more evil and likely to be hellbound. Other conservatives were less evil, moderates more so, liberals very evil, people of other religions or deists horrible, then atheists of course were the worst. Let's just say most of us never ran into or had deep discussions with liberal religious people before or after we left the religion. Before, because of course they were evil, and after, because we didn't want to be around religious people at all. Well, what are liberal Christians or Muslims? Liberals look at the book as flexible and changing, dynamic to the ever-changing world. They see the book as divinely inspired, but not even close to accurate. They believe in the Thomas Aquinas argument that God has written two books, the Bible and nature, and nature requires facts and God requires faith. So until scientific evidence has come out on the subject, you go with the Bible. Once you have facts, then faith is no longer needed. So as science changes, their holy book erodes more and more, but they still like and believe the idea of faith. They don't push their belief on others, they keep it to themselves, and they believe that God has revealed himself to other faiths, and most don't even believe in hell. They understand ambiguity from translation and language barriers and errors. Don Exodus 2, during his early YouTube career, was one of the people who basically threw out the Old Testament because it was shown to be unscientific and invalid, but kept a liberal belief in Jesus and his message. Anything he was ignorant of, he chalked up to God leaving him in the gaps. He deconverted not long after joining the League of Reason. They believe what Galileo said. I am not inclined to believe that the same God who gave us sense, reason, and intellect has intended us to forego their use. Liberal religious people. Religious liberals promote science and evolution. Liberals make the majority of religious scientists. Any new fact they find where science contradicts the Bible, they drop that Bible-based belief. A moderate is somewhere in between. Either they're liberals who are ignorant of science, or they're conservatives who are ignorant of their holy book. So why does someone stay a liberal religious person? There are many reasons. There are social reasons. If your family is religious, there is a strong community in the church. Many stay liberal religious so that their moderate or conservative families don't completely cut them off. Some love the ritual and tradition of it. Some stay religious because they don't think about it at all. Some because they trap themselves in complex but errant logic traps, and most because they haven't heard the right arguments to drop the religion completely. Why am I bringing this up? Because I spent my entire childhood vilifying religious liberals and then sidelining them after deconverting because still in my brain, I labeled them as not real Christians. It took me a lot of time on YouTube and the workplace to find liberal Christians and Muslims. If you noticed, I now put modifiers in my videos to denote fundamentalists to replace all Christians unless I am discussing something that is actually true about all of them. One of the major issues many people have against Thunderfoot is how he paints all Muslims as the same and equally guilty of hate and violence. When many, such as Sufis, are just as pacifistic as most type of Buddhists, who also have their own branches of religious dogma, a few are even violent. Atheists need to be aware that lumping all religions into the same categories creates straw man arguments. If a religious person does not believe what you're claiming, that all people of that religion believes, you're a liar or just appear to be an ignorant bigot and making a false statement about them. Liberal religious are secular humanists. They believe in helping the poor, and the government should stay the hell out of religion and vice versa. Most believe in women's rights, and there are probably just as many confused atheists that are anti-choice as there are confused religious liberals. Liberal Christians have their belief, they keep it to themselves, and they don't vote in ways that affect us. You know how many of us say, so long as you're not going to push it on me, I don't care. That's these people. They do have some confusion, yes. But if you're going to lump everyone together into the same category and say that no Muslim denounced 9/11, you're going to have to back that up with some facts. Unfortunately, the conservatives are the ones you hear about most. You're also going to put a bad taste in their mouth if you straw them about atheists and think that all atheists are just assholes. Dawkins makes the argument in The God Delusion that even the liberal religious are somewhat part of the problem in extremist groups for the idealization and propagation of belief without evidence. I can say that attacking someone who's liberally religious and telling them that they're partially to blame for 9/11 will shut off all communication. You pretty much broke Godwin's law there. As in my video, Overcoming Hateophobia, some people need gradual conditioning and some need flooding, or you'll end all communication, cutting off you or others' chances of making a difference. Because we all have natural biases, if you meet one person in a group, you naturally assume that everyone else is like them. You as a minority are sadly viewed as a representative for atheism, and if you turn people off, it will sour that person's already probably negative view of atheists. For a long time, I thought atheists were just bitter, loudmouth, antisocial assholes because those were the only atheists I'd met. Liberal religious are ripe for the potential deconversion with long-term friendly debates. And even if they don't deconvert, they'll still have a great opinion of atheists and will probably even work with atheists to further the goals of secular humanism. As I've said before, use your freedom of speech wisely. Defend everyone's free speech and do not hold back when you need to. But if you abuse your free speech, saying, all Muslims are complacent in terrorism, no one will listen to you, so you might as well not even have free speech for all the good it's doing you. It's going to be like, oh, that asshole's saying something again. Tune out. Your free speech should be like a scalpel and not a club. For those who lump all Christians or Muslims together in one big group as the same in any topic other than the topic of faith in general, you're showing your ignorance and creating a straw man, something atheists like to think they're above. And nothing turns a person off more than that.